I am Professor Ashok D'Souza from Rani Chennamma University, Belagavi. I am not directly engaged with undergraduate education, but I just want to draw your attention to one fact that I have observed consistently whenever I have been part of local inquiry committees, especially with the management of private education colleges which manage the private education at the undergraduate level. One of the persons here drew the attention to the sensibilities or the attention that we need to pay to each of the disciplines. But when it comes to the engaging faculty and giving them the pay, I have seen that there is lots of discrimination when it comes to science faculty, because we are putting all these liberal kind of education in one basket, BSc and all that. But science faculty are paid higher because it is all unaided kind of posts that are there. And commerce a little lesser. And when it comes to the humanities, the languages and literature, the teachers are paid only peanuts. And that is one important issue. I think if they're whatever given in terms of salary doesn't cover even the fuel, the expenses to commit to the college, I think that's a very important issue when it comes to the inspiration and motivation and other kind of space that we are discussing about. The treatment itself is so kind of discriminatory and derogatory.
I'm Dr. Prabhudev Mundi from Basaveshwar Science College, Bagalkot. And my feeling is, so recently the NAC has a new framework. So if we answer all the questions in the NAC framework, I think the title will be the fulfilled immediately without any sense. So the point is, so now I'll come one by one. So first thing is the curriculum. Just I'll make it a short, so I'll take a point of this. So that is... No, sir, just for the governance and this leadership and management. So one thing, just I'll clear your curriculum, teaching, learning, and evaluation. So these are the main parameters in the NAC. So now the rule is the syllabus has been changed every year, every 3 years. So there is a question again in NAC, what is the change in the syllabus? So the thing is, the point to be clear is, syllabus is going to change. Once we change the syllabus, next comes to the teaching. So don't have a teacher who have adopted to the new technologies. Therefore, the training must be conducted for the teachers. So for this, again, they take care of the principal and management is required. So without a training, there is a change of syllabus. Otherwise, we will keep the same syllabus. So what you learn in MSc? So the same thing, otherwise it will be in BSc 1 or make it as a BSc 3. So reshuffling, so new technology, when it is adopted, the training must be taken. So therefore, even the university has made something like this refresher course and orientation courses like this. So
yes, sir, we do understand. Okay. We do understand the point.
So the last point, I think, in brief, so the role of the principal and management is in such a way, it is so important that, so if you take a physics chemistry lecture, there is a physical chemistry, inorganic chemistry. So there is a three parameter. So then how you are going to choose the particular topic to the particular teacher? So the role of principal and management is a very, very important.
We do understand the point, sir. I request Dr. Varadaraj Bapat to answer this and offer his concluding remarks.
I think the questions were more like comments. We have to be really brief and there is no time, because many of you are really interested in making presentations and also listening to the paper presentations in the next session. So first of all, I would like to be very sorry, because there are so many hands which are still raised and so many people want to ask, or more than asking, want to make their own points, which is a positive thing. But because of paucity of time, it may not happen. So I want to thank the both the participants. I want to quote Chanakya, who has given a very relevant shloka. It says, Lalayet panchavarshani dashavarshani tadayet prapteshu shodashe varshe putre mitra vadacharet. So first 5 years lalayet karna hai, unka thoda ladpyar karna hai. Next 10 years, you can be little bit strict. Rather, you should be strict. But when it comes to undergraduate education, I think it that after 16-year period, where a teacher needs to be a friend, like a friend with the student. So that I think is equally applicable to principals and the leaders. And that's where the challenge is, challenge of this session. That principal needs to be very friendly, but at the same time should not forget that is meant to be a regulator and meant to be the head. Many times we see other extremes. Either people become too strict, not allowing students and the teachers to have their own ingenuity or creativity, or a sort of non-regulation. That is also, I think, not acceptable. So we have to seek a balance between the two. Both the speakers had come out with 3 points each. Again, I'll just make one point, which initially Anuragji had said, that what is the purpose of education? The earlier session was on skill, but I think the purpose of education is much beyond the skill. In the words of Swami Vivekananda, every human being is potentially divine. The purpose of higher education is to bring out that divinity. The knowledge is within, but how to bring it out. So it should not be restricted to skill alone. It should go much, much beyond to make a person good human being. And I think there the role of governance and leadership is very important. And now also Sri Sridharji again had raised 3 points. I think the second point was about college needs to have independent thinking. So I think not only college, it's also applicable to the every faculty, every professor, that they need to have independent thinking. Now the regulatory mechanism may or may not allow that independence. I think some questions were on that line. Since there are good number of regulators here in the form of NAC or in the form of university authorities, I think we all should suggest to them that at least some leeway they should give. If the way, I mean, one of the faculties asked question about the law faculty, if 100% is external exam or 100% is in the hands of the university, I think for the teachers to even think about the way Sridharji had suggested, that they have a scope, becomes too tough. So I think balance is required. Some amount of internal exam or some such thing is to be given. Of course, it's not the structure which is really driving. It is the internal drive, but a supportive mechanism will allow the teachers to come out with that, come out with their own innovations, not just for evaluation, but also to have enable the students to do various other things. So I think with that, the college and teachers should themselves think that they are independent, and regulatory mechanism should allow them to be independent. And these things would really bring out the changes. And several good questions or good comments were also raised. And I think we need a full day if governance and leadership alone needs to be discussed. But usually in Bharatiya Shastras, we say Raja Kalasya Karanam. So Raja equally applicable to the principal, or if we have to go by Sridharji, principal is not required, some other post, whatever it is called, but whoever is a leader of the institution becomes the Kalasya Karanam. So institution kaise chalegi? Is it going to be a motivating place for the teachers? Is it going to be inspiring place for the students? To a great extent depends on wahan ka Raja kon hai. Or usko morally kaisa hai? Does the person has moral authority to really lead the institution becomes very important. And since most of you are leaders at your own places, I would call upon everybody to really implement whatever we have discussed. Dhanyavad.
We come to the end of plenary session number 4, governance, institutional management and leadership. I thank Dr. Varadaraj Bapat for having given a wonderful concluding remarks, and Mr. Anurag Behar and Dr. M.K. Sridhar for having done the plenary sessions. Thank you very much. Thanks, everybody. We are going to break now for another 10 minutes. We'll be having a tea break. We ourselves have delayed it, so we will be cutting short the 15 minutes break into 10 minutes. We'll be back in next 10 minutes. Thank you very much.